Hey guys, it's Broke Crippers and welcome back to my Infinity 16 Juventus Scrimo, where last time left off, I picked up huge wins over for Napoli, and Bologna in the league. I'm just rolling, and I want to also post a big congratulations to the real life Juventus who won that. The real life fixture against Napoli, a very late goal. Well, Napoli were very unlucky to lose that one. Ends up giving Juve the title. Well, I would be really hard done if I was Napoli. Hopefully, Napoli can keep it. Won't let that disrupt them. Hopefully they can keep the race going, but now they're relying on Juventus to drop points.
Your better players would hope to step forward and
really is very, a very good.
How well they played in their previous game to win away against Bologna.
Napoli very unlucky. Juventus are now top of the Serie A in real life and are going for that consecutive. You know, they want to keep the role run of consecutive league titles going. Can they do it? Still a lot of games to go. So we'll see.
The Juventus lineup then. Gigi Buffon plays in goal.
Anyway, the first match of this episode, but I am playing Lyon, the first leg of the knockout stage match. Of course, Tolisso playing against his former club.
The administration of the club.
Which is pretty much a guarantee.
Most successful club.
Yeah, I think it's where
you sign a player in career mode. He's almost guaranteed to play against smaller club. So I wouldn't be surprised if I got drawn against PSG if I get past Lyon. So I'll be looking out for PSG in the next round if I do get past Lyon. That's the plan anyway. Of course. If I get past,
well, away from the
danger zone. Well, I do plan to get past Lyon, but they're not going to be easy to beat. And of course, goal for this season is to win the Champions League, especially considering in real life last season, this came so close that they. We were in the final against just about anybody but Barcelona. They probably would have won, but they came up against Barcelona, who don't care who you are, they will absolutely annihilate you. They gave Valencia a hiding, they gave Celta Vega a hiding, at least I think that's who they were playing at the weekend. Wherever they were, even Messi was taking the piss. They had a penalty. And he passed it off to Suarez. What an absolute dick. He's still the best player in the world, but that was a dick move. That's how little Barcelona gave a shit. They're like, yeah, we already have this match won. We don't even need to score directly from the penalty. Let's pass it off. And yes, Berardi opens the scoring 1-0. What a ball. Pulling onto the head. And he didn't give the Lyon keeper any sort of chance. Lopez is a very good goalkeeper. So, it does take a special kind of shot. Or in this case, a header to beat him. And that's exactly what I produced. So it's 1-0. Oh, I'd love to come out of this with a 3 or 4 goal gap have going into the second leg. Maybe then I can sim it, but by second team. I'm gonna rest the main squad. Of course, that's not this episode. The second match in this episode, of course, is the league game against Inter.
Now he's looking for support. That's perhaps as much down to the conditions that miss Alan.
Gonna be a tough one. Another tough one.
A wet surface and obviously a wet ball. Your timing has got to be spot on. Now the corner.
Bruce.
The goalkeeper wanted it really. That's not the best idea.
Tolisso is not the only former player playing against his former player playing against his former club. Of course, the player I swapped him for, Asamoah, just took Leon's corner there.
Yanga and Biwa. Now by Pogba.
Right, he hit straight Buffon, but he still took the corner. I didn't say he took a good one. The words didn't even cross my mind.
Mathieu Valbuena. That's another
Sandra.
It's good balance to avoid the sliding challenge. Oh, in goes the cross. Offside called, and we can see again now.
Anderson. It's offside.
One because there was a couple of yards in it, I think.
So not exactly the same result as the first goal. Maybe this time though. Here's Berardi again, cutting down the wing again. It's gonna come back to him. Oh, and straight at Lopez.
The teammates who are clearly on the same wavelength.
Anderson.
Still under challenge here, Juventus. They're not quite at the real peak of their performance.
Pogba! What the actual fuck was that, Pogba? I mean, maybe he mishit it? I don't know. I mean, or did I hit it with too much power? Either way, that was a very poor attempt. And quite rightly, I missed. Hit the bar. Run it over for a goal kick that they take. But I win the... Oh, excuse me. Party. Put the ball in, goddammit! Seriously. And he saw the contact there, and he puts that in the back of the net for 2-0. Oh, but he love tapped it. Seriously.
Yanga and Biwa. Medina.
That's probably one of the most feeble shots I've ever seen. And I press circle, so. Oh, I don't know what his excuse is. So can he get an assist against his former club? No, he hits straight the goalkeeper, even though I was trying to bend it into the box, which didn't happen. I have to get Tolisso to work on his curve. Maybe that was the problem. And speaking of PSG, oh wow, that's actually the real life fixture that is happening tonight in real life. Although PSG are home tonight. He did set the Stade de France. No, it's time for Bridge. That's the second leg.
Teams lined up, ready to go.
So PSG have to get past the real life count. That's about against Chelsea. But as this game likes to pair me off against teams by players from in career mode, but I fully expect PSG to get past Chelsea. So sorry about that, Chelsea. You're probably pretty screwed. Like in real life. So, yeah. Again, doubly sorry about that. Real life, I had nothing to do with it. You're just terrible. And your teammates and our backs are injured. Which may as well be a personal invite for Ibrahimovic to come and mess your shit up. And the man does not need a second invitation. He will come and he will mess shit up.
Let's see the replay now.
the ball with a fucking intriguing shot. But, he put it away, so it's 2-0. Nice. 5 goals in the Champions League now for Paulo Dybala.
Mattia Valbuena.
Pogba. Anderson. Dybala, no one is picking him up. Oh, I passed it into the net. It's a second for Berardi. It's a third for me. Leon's defense went to rat shit. I don't know where their defenders were. They fell asleep. I could have scored with Dybala, but I saw Berardi coming into a very good position. He couldn't miss. I mean, Lopez could have easily probably saved the shot if I'd taken the shot with Dybala, but Berardi wasn't in that position. So, it's 3-0.
As the game gets underway.
And that hope of getting perhaps 4 goals is definitely on now. Because I only need one more. I'm not going to stop if I get 4 goals. Most before the 90. He always has to go for as many goals as possible.
Of course, Serie A fixture.
We're through again. And Berardi is again in our position. And we hit the bar. Berardi hit the bar. You can't write that shit.
Berardi! Decent block.
Ratti, oh, cleared before he could take a second, but the cherry. Mopu. I assume that's not how you pronounce it. It is, that guy might want to change his surname. It's almost as bad as he's being called Can. And everyone pronouncing it wrong. Care how Germans pronounce it, that's your own business. But in English, C-A-N is can. If it was Chan, there'd be an H in it. There isn't, so stop calling him that, English. There's commentators. There's, you are not German. You don't have to pronounce it the same way.
This could be a chance. Here's the shot. And it's a shot that the goalkeeper can deal with quite comfortably.
Anderson,
is
he going to get there? He did!
Well, it will be dealt with easily by the defenders there. It wasn't a great cross in truth. Now they can build from
the weak attempt. Oh, keep the ball. Yes, Marlow. Well, ball to Berardi. Is he going to get there? Yes.
And in goes the cross. Tries to punch it away.
Too close to the goalkeeper.
Much happier times.
Pogba.
Juventus these days. Fantastic Serie A triumph in the 11-12 season.
Back with Pogba, but
looking extremely good here. A very controlled performance.
I come with him there. Verratti. Yes, good work, buddy. Young Italian center mid. And now we counterattack. Sandro, he still has the ball. Oh. Anderson, can we get the 4th? Berardi! He got it! And he got a hat trick as well! Would you believe it? It was like it was written.
Super celebration. To get a hat trick is a fantastic experience, and he's just done that.
What a header. It starts with a header. It ends with a header. And it started with Berardi. And it ends with Berardi. This is not an error. I'm sure there are coins. Yeah, they actually are, to be honest. I did not plan that. I wanted to get 4 goals, but I didn't. I was starting to seriously doubt if I'd get that 4th goal. Oh, but I did. And there's the full time whistle. The second leg is looking very, very juicy. You to say the very least. He's a hat trick from Berardi. He paired with Apollo Dybala special for a 4-0 win. Somehow Dybala got man of the match. Really? How? How did he get man of the match? Berardi scored a hat trick. I don't understand this game sometimes. And the Chelsea PSG game finished 2-2. Champions. A realistic scoreline.
Paris Saint-Germain 2. Juventus 4. Olympic Lyonnais 0.
Of course, in the game that gives PSG the advantage, if that happens in real life, that would give Chelsea the advantage, because they're the away team in real life. Of course, Rugani has to come in for the suspended Benucci, who got sent off in the game against Napoli in the last episode. Good, if you did not see that. Of course, Paul Pogba is also is back from the suspension, having missed the Napoli game. Because he got sent off against Bologna. Because in the last episode, I didn't really time my challenges well. I was kind of bad at it. I don't know how that was, but
I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me. Sorry.
It's not gonna happen in this episode.
Juventus.
My focus is on keeping 11 men on the pitch and getting the win. Straight away. Ooh. Ooh. Early corner, 3rd minute. Where have been for Ben Anderson to that ball? Yo! It was almost an own goal. Anderson wins another corner. This time on the opposite side.
It maybe should be a goal, but in fact, the technology says no, and who's going to argue with that?
So seriously, all you have to do is stick out a leg and you couldn't have cleared it. Dybala takes the corner. Punched out by hand damage. So Pogba. Oops, it in. Anderson! Why? No, not again! That's the exact same thing that happened in the last game, only a little different. He didn't connect with the cross proper. And puts it out for a goal kick.
Looking for Biani, the first choice player on the right of midfield, is out for the business.
Actually, forgot to see who had the worst shot ever.
They can get away.
Not trying to quote that Simpson character. That was a really, really bad shot. Sandro, come on. Into Dybala! Ah! This time at least he produces a save from Handanovic. Off his elbow.
It's really cleared the danger with that strong header.
Baratti. Now wide to Anderson. Back in. To Tolisso! No! It's. Anderson, yes! Felipe Anderson finally breaks the deadlock after another mad scramble. Oh, god damn it. How did... I mean, why? Why did...
Analyzing again.
I think it was Berardi who kind of like bowled it to the keeper. Granted, I'm glad that Handanovic parried it instead of catching it and scooping it up, because that would, because otherwise Anderson wouldn't have scored his 10th goal. And I'd still be a bit pissed off. He did have parry it, and we're 1-0 up. So Sunrise Sunset.
Aristocrats of Italian football. I just hope we're going to get a game to live up to the billing here.
Jesus. Gracias. Condobia. Very soft shot from Condobia. You expect better from him. Berardi. Perisic is giving chasing. Berardi won it though. Oh. Healthy! Imagine. Oh, that would have actually been a very soft penalty, to be fair. Kind of like, well, I was going to say kind of like the Spurs penalty against Manchester City at the weekend, but actually, probably, you know, just different situations, because I'm sorry, I'm a Liverpool fan, so I hate Raheem Sterling's guts. Because that little shit doesn't know the word loyalty and doesn't appreciate everything we did for him.
Well, it's very good positional play, and he's read the situation perfectly with that interception.
But the ball did not hit his hand. I'm going to hold my hands up and say I laughed at him, because the penalty should not have been a penalty, but that was not, it wasn't. It was not a penalty. Didn't hit Sterling's hand, and that's coming from a Liverpool fan. And I want to see Sterling suffer. Like I said, I laughed my ass off that it was him who practically cost City the match, because then again, their defense didn't help, because Eriksen practically walked through the defense because no one was picking him up. Lamela's pass. The defenders may as well not even mean there.
Alvarez. Terrific tackle.
Again, if they weren't there, he probably would have caught himself. Again,
Rodrigo Palacio here.
I don't know where I'm going. Play this. With the passing, the movement, take it from me.
To make the passing possible.
The penalty should not have been given. It did not hit Sterling's hand.
Ibala.
Personally, I'm glad it was given, and I'm glad to say lost.
Great stop. Shots on here. By his standards, that's extraordinary.
So, yeah. I'm glad it was given, but it shouldn't have been given.
Condogbia. Alvarez.
There's the halftime whistle. Currently 1-0. Not a healthy lead. Inter are very much still in this. My players are getting tired, which is not ideal. Not ideal whatsoever. Because, yeah, they get tired. How the hell am I supposed to win this match? Ideally, I should take them off. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bring on Cuadrado, Zaza, the man who actually scored that late winner against Napoli on Saturday, and Bahouli. So I'm going all French into the center of midfield, along with Talisa and Paul Pogba. Berardi and Talisa will have to see out the rest of the game, because I don't have 5 substitutions that I can make. I can only make 3.
Inter kick off the second half. Gary Medel. Santon. Prado.
Pogba! What was that for? What was that? What was that? What actually was that?
Nazionale fixture.
That was pathetic. The Dorado.
There's a spice involved in this. There's certainly be a good atmosphere.
Zaza. He couldn't get the show away. A very good block by Jesus. Did very well to not only stop the shot, but not to concede a penalty. I mean, if he gets that wrong, if Zaza gets to show away, it could be 2-0, or it's a penalty, and it may as well be 2-0. And with the ball off the pitch, I don't know who my penalty taker would be.
Perisic. As for Inter, what about their next game, Alan?
Don't want to stop him.
Extremely tight and tense match.
Turn, shoot! Oof! I'll take a throw.
Inter want to make a change.
Here comes Jovetic. One for Palacio.
And in goes the cross.
It's Inter Milan goal in search for an equalizer, and Cuadrado cannot double my lead. This is another look at the save from Handanovic. He almost took out Urochoa. Pogba! Oh!
He's got it away.
Freaking hell, man.
Wasteful pass, unforced error, really.
And I'm getting very unlucky. We have hit the bar a few times in this episode now. Come on, Brad. Hey, Pogba. This time. Off out. Out off the guy off on the line. In for another corner. It comes to Tolisso. He shoots. It's straight to Jesus.
Ranocchia. Guarín. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Hondogbia.
Tolisso. Foul. Bahouli. Turns. Brody! Straight at Handanovic. Stop doing that!
The home supporters are trying to help the team in this situation. They're encouraged by the lead, but they're fearful perhaps that this team might lose it.
Well, they won't want to give anything silly away. The opposition are chasing the ball, trying to get it back and trying to get back into this match.
Zaza! 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 How did he miss? How did he actually miss? This is why you're on the bench, mate. This is why you're on the bench. Well, that and the fact that Dybala can't stop scoring, but mostly that is the reason why you were on the bench.
Perisic.
Now he can't make a simple goddamn pass. It's Berardi, who has absolutely nothing left in the tank. Push it. And for fuck's sake, Zaza! How did he miss? He actually missed again. Oh my god. I'm never bringing him on as a sub again.
Fine save he's made there. He's not let the ball escape his grasp. Goalkeeper pushing them on.
Well, acting like the captain there, why not?
Juventus.
Yes, I thought it was a foul. Work at the
back. That's what's got them the result here.
Oh, but no, it's full time. I got the 3 points. And barely. It didn't help that and I got unlucky as hell, but a 1-0 win is good enough. Just like at the start of the season. Felipe Anderson's goal was enough to give me 3 more valuable points in the league title hunt. Yeah!
Udinese 1, Hellas Verona 0. Let's have a look at what
the confirmation that Benucci has served his 1-game ban and will be back in the squad for the semi-final cup game against Milan.
In third, Roma with 48 points.
That is going to be
46 points. With a game in hand.
Yeah. Hectic.
43 points. In 6th, Palermo with 41 points. In 7th, Chievo Verona with 39 points. In 8th, Inter with 39 points, but only behind on goal difference. Bottom of the table, Frosinone with
39 points. Win actually confirms that at least I can't finish lower than in the Europa League spot, but I'm aiming for the title. So I have a cup game against the Milan. Also, I have a league game against Atlanta. But don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss that episode. Oh, if you're wondering, what is this up on a Tuesday? The schedule thing has changed. You will now see. The video you would normally see on Thursday, you will now see on Tuesday. Maybe because I'm putting out more court here mode now. Who since I finished The Walking Dead and the only games I have in the wings for me to play require me to finish other games first. Otherwise, everyone will be massively confused. So, until next time, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And make sure and like if you enjoyed. Like I said, subscribe for more videos. And until next time, I hope you all have a very good day.